Last time we talked about trading him. Today we're talking about how good he has been. What is up, viewer out there watching this video? Arcs back here, bringing you this time another video talking about Ilya Kovalchuk. Oh boy. What a story we have here. Ilya Kovalchuk is currently at 8 points in 8 Montreal Canadiens games, and that is really gosh darn good for a guy that the Habs previously acquired via free agency on a $700,000 deal. Now, $700,000, that's a lot to you and me, but for the NHLers, it is literally the smallest contract possible. This is smaller than your entry-level deal. This is tiny. And Ilya Kovalchuk went with it. And Ilya Kovalchuk is a point per game. And Ilya Kovalchuk has revitalized this Canadiens team that everybody is on board. Just to clear things up, we made our video the other day about trading Ilya Kovalchuk because of the fact that we kinda had to. When we brought in Ilya Kovalchuk, we kind of knew that if he's really good and the Habs are nowhere near the playoffs by the trade deadline, flip the guy for a draft pick or something. Just, you know, use the asset correctly. And that's kind of the angle we needed to tackle in our Kovalchuk video the other day. But at the same time, just because a guy's trade bait doesn't mean he can't also be good. And Ilya Kovalchuk has been very good. And we talked about some of the things that Ilya Kovalchuk has been able to do in his 8 games here, but it goes beyond the 8 points in the 8 games. It goes beyond that. It is seriously changing the dynamic of this team. Everybody, and I mean everybody, has been on board with Ilya Kovalchuk ever since he stepped onto the ice, played his first shift, scored his first few points, and just totally taken control over this team. Now, I don't want to say he's the best player out there. That's not what I'm trying to say here. I'm trying to say that Ilya Kovalchuk's presence alone gives him such a huge boost of fan respect, fan attention, and teammate engagement in the game that it's so weird. It's so weird what one player can do to your team. One player who used to be a star, one player who arguably still is. A guy who is past his prime days in the NHL as a 36-year-old, and today is still tearing things up with 8 points in 8 games, bringing all the star power, all the flair, and just totally taking things into his own end. Huge, vicious snipes against Philadelphia. Coming in against the Vegas Golden Knights on some really nice plays. And just totally taking control of what he's been given. After a few unfortunate games with the LA Kings where he wasn't utilized, he's been placed into the top 6 here in Montreal, and he's been riding. Ilya Kovalchuk is absolutely on fire right now. And aside from Carey Price, he's probably the hottest Hab on the team. I think probably the thing that has surprised me the most is the fact that Kovalchuk still has that absolutely deadly wrister. We saw this in his first goal as a Hab, in overtime against the Ottawa Senators, where he slowed down as he was coming in on the wing. He's slowed, and he's looking through the slot, looking, while he's just going back and forth with the puck. He's basically not even moving at this point. He's eyeing his teammate the entire way through. Then he absolutely just throws it towards the net off the bar and in. What an absolute sniper this guy is. Against the Flyers, we got a little bit of a taste of that, as well as Kovalchuk's offensive IQ, his positioning, his ability to find space on open ice. His first goal against Philadelphia, he's jamming away at the rebound out in front of the net. Nobody's really on him, and he's able to get a nice one to go. And his second goal against Philadelphia, oh boy. It's Thomas Tatar who throws it right through in front of the high slot. Kovalchuk picks it up, and just like his first goal against Ottawa, he's coming in really slowly, dragging the puck out to the side, and he absolutely just throws it towards the net, rips it in. And that's something that we have gotten used to in these 8 games that Ilya Kovalchuk has played. Then you take a look at his goal against the Vegas Golden Knights. It's another showcase of his ability to find space, coming into the open areas, jamming away at a loose puck out in front for the rebound. You could see how excited he gets, how excited the team gets, and how excited the Bell Center gets when Ilya Kovalchuk gets on the board. If it were up to me, I want to keep this guy. Sign him to another contract. Look at how good he's been playing here. But obviously, because hockey is hockey and it's a business, we did need to discuss the idea of trading this player that the Canadiens just acquired, because that is literally the business side of things. I'm thinking if Ilya Kovalchuk can help push this Canadiens team into the playoffs, then hell yeah. That's awesome. I'd love for that to happen. If they're really close, just barely out of the playoffs, I don't know if they trade him. Honestly, I don't know. I think they probably keep him, maybe even sign him to a year or a 2-year deal or whatever, just so they can at least try to replicate this success next year. Because let's face it, the Canadiens over the past year haven't necessarily done anything to add to their roster aside getting a few depth guys and adding the prospects they already had in their system onto the main team. That's pretty much it. The Aho thing didn't work out so well. They tried to go after Panarin, at least that's what people said that they were trying to do. That didn't go so well. So Montreal has had a really bad string of luck when it comes to acquiring these players in the offseason, these big superstar power players who can help your team out in the short term. Obviously, I don't want to call Kovalchuk a superstar, but the way he's been playing in Montreal, he's pretty much the Habs superstar right now. And this is a guy who does expire at the end of the year. And if he isn't trade bait, and he isn't gone by the trade deadline, I want to bring this guy back. Don't lose this guy for nothing. This guy has revitalized the team. And I know a season is 82 games long, and one player coming in for 8 games and changing the dynamic for those 8 games isn't the end of the world. But boy, oh boy, does it feel good. You can't tell me I'm wrong about that, right? It still feels good. And I know it's going to keep feeling good because Kovalchuk has been so good and he's been meshing so well, and I can't wait to see how things progress. From Nick Suzuki to top line minutes with Thomas Tatar and Philippe Danault, and also being on the second power play. Remember, this guy's on the second unit. Things have changed, and a lot of people will be the first to tell you that, hey, Kovalchuk has kind of helped solve the Canadiens' line juggling problems, and they still don't have Drouin or Gallagher. That's crazy. The Habs have won 4 out of their last 5 games, and I think Ilya Kovalchuk has a big part to do in those performances. In those 5 games, Ilya Kovalchuk is at, guess how many? 5 points. And the Canadiens are currently 8 points out of a playoff spot. That is quite a big hurdle, I will acknowledge that. I wouldn't be surprised if the Habs didn't make the playoffs this year, but what I'm saying is there's a chance. And it feels like there's a chance. It didn't feel like there was a chance a few weeks ago before they signed Kovalchuk. It felt like the end of the world in Montreal, and everybody knows that. 2 separate 8-game losing streaks? Boy, oh boy, that sucks. But 8 points is 8 points. And if they keep on winning games, if Kovalchuk keeps doing his thing, I wouldn't be surprised if they clawed back and made things interesting. Hey man, let's draft 14th overall. That's the meme that's going around Twitter right now, that the Canadiens are going to be so good, but still fall short because that's what Montreal does, that they're going to pick 14th overall in the draft. That is the last eligible pick for non-playoff teams, and it means that you are the best non-playoff team. So that's a little bit of a joke. I hope I didn't actually insinuate any higher powers that be to illustrate a situation that looks like that. But I hope you enjoyed this video, social that I trust Line 9. And bye.